today's topic is scarcity mentality versus abundance mentality. And on today's webinar, we're gonna talk about the difference between scarcity and abundance mentality. We will talk about why is it important to live in an abundance mentality. I will teach you a simple exercise that will help you to switch from a scarcity mindset to abundance mindset. We will discuss six important categories that you have to fulfill in your life in order to feel happy, in order to be successful in life. And at the end of this webinar, I will invite you to my online course, which is called Program for Success, and I will tell you how you can attend it for free. So let's start our webinar. And all people can be divided into two groups. The first group of people believe that this world is abundant and there is enough for everyone. No matter the subject, there are endless possibilities in this world, and everyone can receive what he wants. And the other group of people who believe that resources are limited. So you have to fight for what you want in your life. You should be aggressive and sometimes even cold, selfish and tough, or somebody else will get it before you and you will be left without anything. So the most important, what I want you to remember from today's webinar, is that people who live in mind state of abundance will realize many more of their dreams, wishes and goals than those who live in the state of limitations or scarcity mentality. Therefore, I would like to encourage you to pay attention to your thoughts, because your thoughts are your beliefs. And if you notice that often you think that there is not enough of something, if you notice that you are afraid that you won't get something and somebody else will get it, then you might be living in a scarcity mentality. So if you think that there is always somebody who is smarter, stronger, faster than you, then you might be living in a scarcity mentality. And today I would like to offer you one exercise that can help you to program yourself to live in an abundance mentality. And I would like to ask you to create a list of things that you are thankful for. Let me turn on the slide. So this exercise will help you to get out from under your detrimental limiting beliefs. Every night before going to sleep, and this is very important, before going to sleep, think about, or even better, write down on paper what you are grateful for. So you should create a list of things you are thankful for. And it is important to do it before going to sleep, because this is the time when your critical mind is tired and you won't fight you as much as if you do this in the morning or during the day. So I want you to fall asleep with feeling of gratitude, with feeling that your life is good and abundant. So before you go to sleep, your inner critic does not have the energy to fight you. And this is the time, this is the best time when you should write things that you are grateful for. Here are some examples of what you might write down. Maybe you had a nice conversation with your friend today. So you can write down that you are grateful to have such a good friend in your life. Another example, maybe you went to a gym today and you can write down that you are grateful to yourself for taking care of your body. Or you are grateful to the gym owner for opening a gym near your house. Maybe today you went to the store and the person at the cash register was very nice to you and friendly. So you can write down that you are grateful to live in such a nice neighborhood. So every day, just little by little, expand your list of things that you are grateful for. You can write small things, you can write big things, it does not matter. The most important that you should have a long list of things that you're grateful for. So this is how you're gonna train your brain to live in an abundance mentality, when you're gonna see a long list of things that you're grateful for, of good things. So you can call it as your list of gratitude or your journal of gratitude. Let's get back to the topic that we discussed 2 weeks ago, how to make your dreams come true and how to program yourself for success. And today's topic and the is 100% related to the topic that we have discussed 2 weeks ago. On the last webinar, I was teaching that you should create a long list of wishes, dreams, and goals. The minimum should be 50 items in your wish list. So if you missed that webinar, please, after watching this one, go and watch the previous one. The link is already below this video in the description section. So if you will practice and train yourself to live in an abundance mentality, then you can easily create a long list of wishes. Because you will believe that you can achieve anything. You will believe in your dreams, you will believe in yourself, and you will believe that you can have those things in your life. So there is a lot of everything for everyone. On the last webinar, we spoke about the importance of being open to all the possibilities that life is offering to you. And we have discussed 6 rules of how to make a wish so it will come true. Again, if you did not watch that webinar, please watch it right after this one. So the first rule, make your wish on your own behalf without including other people. So you should not include your husband, your wife, your mother, your father, your children, your friends in your wish. So all those people should not be a condition for your wish to come true. And if you do include, you know, your kids in your wish list, if you include your husband in your wish list, then it means that you live in a scarcity mentality. So do not put another person as a condition for your wish to become true. Example, a woman might have a wish and she might say something like this: I want my husband to love me. And it sounds good, right? But this is the wish of a person who lives in a scarcity mentality. So she wants to feel loved, but maybe her husband is not capable of loving. Maybe his way of loving her is to be provider, is to make money, or maybe to fix refrigerator at home. And she wants him to hug her more often, and she wants him to tell her words of affirmations. So there are 2 different love languages that those people use. So remember, this is your wish list and it should be only about you, not other people. So this woman, she put her husband as the condition for her happiness. So what is really hidden behind this woman's wish? The desire to be loved, the desire to be treated respectfully, the desire to feel worthy, and the desire to be special. So let's rephrase this wish from the abundance point of view, or abundance mentality. It would sound as simple as, I want to be loved, or I want to feel loved. So in this way, we're not even including husband in this dream. So you can receive a love not only from your husband, but also from your family members, from your friends, or from your kids. So you can write down, I want to be treated respectfully by other people. I want to be loved by other people. So now it's not only about one person, your husband, Now, this is the dream about having healthy relationships with all people around you, with your friends, with your co-workers, with your parents, with your kids, etc. So when you live in a scarcity mentality, you limit yourself. And when you live in an abundance mentality, you are open. This way, your relationships will improve. Relationships with your family members can improve, relationships at work can improve, and your friendship can improve. So you get the idea. Instead of having one wish, I want my husband to love me, you can create 5 or maybe 10 or maybe more wishes. So you can create meaningful relationships in your life, not only with one person, but you know, with all people around you. And usually it's not about one person. Usually when a person says, I want my husband to love me, or I want my girlfriend to love me, it's not about husband or girlfriend. It's about how this person feels in general, about your self-esteem, about your self-confidence, about your boundaries with other people. So the key is not to limit yourself. And do not make another person responsible for your wish. Do not make your happiness depends on another person. All your wishes should be made on your own behalf and should be only about you. So there is a total of 6 rules of how to make your wish so it will come true, how to increase chances of your wish come true. And we discussed that topic on the last webinar. So please go and watch that webinar after this one. The link is in the description of this video.